Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching Terra TerraFirMeadCraft featuring the TerraFirmaPunk mod pack. A little something strange happened right at the beginning of this episode. I'm actually recording this after I'm completely done, so you'll see what happens with that. The first part of the video and audio just didn't record, so I'm not sure what's going on there. But what I was saying was that even though I'm pretty sure I had said that we weren't going to be getting back to the kind of industrial modded stuff for a little while, that I had rather a lot of stuff already, and that's pretty much where we're going to get into. So I'll repeat that again, and we'll get right into it. I took a quick look, and I had quite a lot of stuff already done. So we're going to get as far as we can with this, and I think that's going to involve the carpenter and making that auto workbench, which will go into the thermionic fabricator. So I've been sort of assembling stuff, and I thought I should probably record before I got too far into it. Made the clockwork engine. Let's see, we're still going to need a workbench and one of those hammers. So let's brave the snow, and it's dark again, good grief. We'll brave the snow out here and try to get a... I'm pretty sure there's a hammer out here. If there's not one out here, I know that there's one... Yeah, here we go. I know that there's one in one of those barrels by the door as well. For the workbench... I'm sort of still in coffee hacky mode here, so expect a few, at least one weird edit. I thought I had. Maybe I used it for something. No biggie. I just thought I had one already. Getting a little weird lag, too. Not the usual kind of lag. Not really sure what's going on with that. I'm gonna stop looking now and just go ahead and make one. I've got all of this white cedar. I wish I could use it for regular things. How much sycamore do I have in the thing by the door? Not enough. Not nearly enough. And we're hungry. All right. Really want to use ash, but it's here, it's available, and I hope I can mix and match like this. Yes, I can. Now watch, I'll find it in like here or something. All right, so this auto workbench, this is all going to go in the craft, in the carpenter, so I need to make sure that I have everything that I've got, or got everything that I need rather. So we've got the two gears, the mechanical board that I just made, the crafting table, steam hammer. Let's see. This, that, thank you, Move Giles. Thank you very much. Blueprint. I thought I had two of those. I'm glad I checked. Now, where are those guys? Here. And... I wish we didn't have to click every single time. And the clockwork engine, which is right there. And that should do it. Oh, and we need... we need one of those. And a bucket of creosote. So let me get my cough out of the way, and I'll go get that stuff, and we'll be right back. All right, so we've got the stuff. I went ahead and put it in the carpenter. Poor Garibaldi. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not. Sneezing his little head off. All right. Let's see. Steam hammer and workbench. We need to put that there. And that is going to go there. And that'll make us an auto workbench. and we don't have any power, that's fine. And I'm pretty sure it only needs one. 1,000 millibuckets, slime based. Let's move this guy over and see what we can do with it. All right, so that looks like it's working, and I'll be back when we've got an auto workbench. All right, this is gonna take just short of forever. I'm not even sure how much, I don't want to wind that up too much. Not sure how much power this one gives, this clockwork engine, but we're gonna see if we can get some, hi there, stop it. See if we can get some steam engine, some steam back over here from there. Oh man, do I only have the one boiler? I think I do. Did I pull the boiler up? Because the only thing we can make right now is the hobbyist's engine. And nope, here's the boiler. Okay. Did I make two of those? I don't remember. No matter. We'll end up using that. Not sure where I'm gonna bring. Yeah, it might just come out under here and go up under the water. I do know that I wanted to put it along this trench here. The only problem with that is that if you pile dirt on top of the pipe, it breaks the pipe. So not entirely sure how well thought out that was, but that's all right. Let's see, did I have, I thought I made two boilers at one point. Hey, I sure did, look at that. And we might actually have enough to make this little guy. This plate. Brass? No, I need copper plates. I need three copper plates. And that, and that, and the two gold-plated gears. And I hope I'm not robbing from something else. So, three copper plates is more nuggets than I've got there. They are out front. Don't need, I think I just need two of these. Two bars will make three plates, I believe. And I really hope that I don't need the Railcraft plates for that. Because they're not moving. So you're saying I can't even make a centrifuge until I make rolling machines. Is that how that's going to go? Or do I have to go fix some more recipes? And I can't, I'd love to be able to make pistons. I guess I can, but no, I can't. See, because I can't make a piston. Barring the seed oil problem and making enough of that, that's not an issue. I can't make a piston because I need to make a pressure converter, and that requires a thermionic fabricator. So I guess I'll just have to. I thought it required more than that, but it's not so bad. But let's see. Thermionic fabricator, interesting, does not require, it requires a solid, okay, so it's a boiler and the fire charge and bricks. Gold gears, and one of these, which shouldn't be an issue. Okay, I guess I won't be doing this anytime soon then. I just wanted to do a hobbyist steam engine. So we could actually, you know, get some steam power going. But I can't make these guys. Until I get a rolling machine. And that's going to require way more pistons than I've seen so far. Cool. All right. Go back to winding. Are these guys, are y'all going to grow ever? You know, I'm just asking. The eternal twilight of, or eternal mid-morning of childhood, I guess. All right. But yeah, all of this, and we're still not even halfway. It's just going to take a while. Well, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and, while we're kind of waiting on this to happen, I am going to go ahead and put some of this stuff down. And I may well run out of pipe. Hi there. Thank you. But the nice thing is, all we have to do is find another abandoned high-rise. And we'll have all the pipe that we could possibly want. I might actually run out. Actually, you know what? I'm going to grab the stuff from the house that I never used. Because I decided to move all of my engineering stuff out across the way anyway. So I'm just going to go pull this up. And we'll try not to drown. Okay. Well, that's not good. Yeah, let's not do that. We'll just grab all of this. Oh, come on. What was that? Alright, so we're gonna have to. Yeah, we're gonna have to dig this out. Ah. That's alright. And I think. I think it's just gonna come out here. Go down here. And then just go straight across. And now I don't have to worry about it. And I've got six left. I'm not sure that's going to be enough. What did I say? That I was gonna, was this going to bring it in like directly behind the wall? All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wall. 6 and a wall. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and a wall. Okay. So if we want to come up, I guess behind the wall, it's not going to matter. Oh, yeah. Been playing too many other packs here lately. All right. And I'll probably need to go ahead and get some support beams so that stuff doesn't fall. Yep, not even halfway. So let's do a little bit of construction, shall we? We're going to have to go in quite a ways, actually. Birch support beams. Where are all of my support beams? There they are. I knew I had a bunch. All right. Is that going to help at all? No. Yeah, well. That's pretty much what I need. Oh, and now we're into dirt. Okay, stone. That's fine. I think that's fine. We should be fairly well insulated from any cave-ins. So I guess what I'll do, come back over here and decide where I want it. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to need to use this clockwork engine on this for the rest of this little auto table build anyway. Because if I pull it up, I'm going to lose all of the progress, the pitiful amount of progress that I've made so far. So I think I'm going to put... I think I'm going to put the steam coming in here. And we'll just put the engine over here and then put the carpenter on top of that so I don't have to really worry about it too much. And... there we go. Hey, cool. Excellent. Six, and now we're out. So I will have to go get some more of these. That's fine. The question is, how shall I do... I think what I'll do for this is we're going to put it out here. No. What was that? There we go. Now I have like maybe a little trap door or something here. And what I'll need to do is... come on. We'll do that. Should have the gravel. Is the gravel gonna break? Yep, see? That's ridiculous. That you can't cover up the pipes with gravel or dirt. So I guess I'll have to find some more stones. And brick that up. It's fairly silly, but that's all right. So that's going to take a while, and we're just going to leave that there. And I guess the rest of this will stay. Let's actually go see if there's anything that I've already got that we can use to sort of cover that up. Even if it's... you know what? I think I just found a use for this stuff. It will have little trail snaking all the way across the yard over here. Stop it. I don't, why don't you get out of there? Yeah, why don't you get out of there? Thank you. This might actually not look too bad. I don't know why it's lagging like that. That is so weird. I mean, it's not like I'm on a server or anything. It feels like server lag, but it can't possibly be. All right, so stay tuned. Next time we will have, should have, a completed auto workbench, I think is what that is, auto workbench. I'm not planning to use it as an intermediate stage. Because that's build craft stuff that that I'm not dealing with at all yet. So we're just trying to get to the basic power setup here. And so we'll have that next time. And Thermi, we'll be able, might even be able to make this thing next time. I'll go ahead and do the gearbox and the gears, because the these gold gears are just irritating. I'll figure it out. Gold sheets, that's a lot of gold. That might be worth it, though. Anyway. Everything else is just iron tank wall. It's two double sheets, not a big deal. It's just a matter of having the actual resources to do it. And I know I can make this. So we should be good. We should be able to actually make a thermionic fabricator, hopefully even by next episode. Wouldn't that be cool? And then all I have to do, because this thing will take forever to do anything with this to begin with, and certainly for a thermionic fabricator. So we're going to have to figure out the power situation and do that up sort of permanently here. And hopefully that steam engine will actually work. May have to redo the way I envision this working, so I'll have a valve that I can shut it off. And have it actually accessible here. But we'll figure all that out, hopefully in the next couple of episodes. So thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. And we'll see y'all next time. Bye. I don't want to cover that up because I want to get that valve out of there. So there.